Next, we have a Republican out of Gaylor. He is Kenneth Glasser. Again, 3 minutes for an introduction and general statements, followed by 8 minutes of your group prepared. And we have other questions. Go ahead, Kenneth.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'd like to thank you for coming out. It's a nice day. It's a warm up tomorrow, so it'll be better to have something more national to do. I'm a Northern Michigan native. I've lived in Gaylor all my life. Business for 30 years, insurance agency, so I know what it's like to scratch out a living and how difficult it can be at various times. I know what it's like to put my paycheck in the drawer because I need to make payroll for everybody else in my office. For 10 years, I have been a county commissioner elected official, and for the last four, I've served as the chairman of the board of that state county. So I have a perspective on what happens in government and in business and how they interface. I stayed in Northern Michigan because I love this country and I love its people. I wanted to raise my family here and I wanted to live all my days here hunting and fishing and enjoying the great things that we have in Michigan. Part of what's wrong here in Michigan today is we've adopted a negative attitude toward our economic situation. Yes, we're losing people, we have problems, we can overcome these things. The difficulty that we've had is we've not been able to come together to work on solutions. We instead take ideological positions and are unwilling to work together in government. And at Seattle County, we've been successful in bringing various governments together to accomplish things for the people. Situations that did not exist prior to going to VNN work. There was a lot of action. We were able to get the cities, the township, and the county government to work together to bring a crossover project to Gaylor and Gaylor and probably a city crossover. So that was done by a cooperative effort. Again, I want to thank you all for coming out and thank the promoters of this event for putting it on.
First question, your views relative to Michigan opting out of Obama's health care reform?
Well, I think that that's a very good idea, and I also believe that the health care as it was created is unconstitutional. Most of the legislation was designed to hobble insurance companies and to raise your rates to the point where you would want to go into a public option, but oops, we didn't put enough public option in there, so we're going to have to come back and fix it. It's a stupid piece of legislation, and it should be repealed. As an alternative, we will fight it.
How do you feel about the fair tax to lighten the tax burden on Michigan taxpayers?
I think the fair tax is a very good idea. In fact, I endorse it. I'll just give you a few broad strokes so that you can understand what it is. It's increasing the sales tax 3.75%, eliminating Michigan income tax, giving each and every individual immediate stimulus by giving you a tax break. No longer have to file your state income tax return to pay for compliance. It eliminates several other taxes that are hidden taxes that businesses pay, Michigan business tax, the surcharge, 6 mils of school tax that businesses pay. It also has a prepaid because raising your sales tax 9.75% is very aggressive. In other words, poor people will pay a whole lot more than those that make a lot of money because they spend so much to meet their basic needs. That's cured by putting in a prepaid where you send out a check to folks to compensate them for that based on their income. There are more details at www.fairtax.org. I encourage you to take a look at it. Yes, I do support it.
With the delusion of visioning as a way for public planning and land use, how will you ensure that the rights of private property owners are represented? And further, do you think that it's being steered by Mayor Gunn's Michigan land uses to whatever?
Well, I have been through the visioning process at Seattle County as a planning commissioner. And yeah, it's being steered by groups. They give you a grant and you come in and go through the process. What I would favor in opposition to that is citizen involvement. You know, zoning is great when it doesn't apply to you, but as soon as it affects your setback and the nature of zoning. My opinion when I was on the planning commission was if everybody left the room angry, we probably did the right thing. Basically, you want to leave it alone. Zoning is there to help property owners reach the best and greatest use. And that's the way it should be administered. It should not be administered to exclude certain uses that people want to do. They're like, they need to be encouraged to use it. That's one of the things that's wrong with Michigan. We don't need professionals coming here to tell us how to do things. We need to be involved as citizens. That's why I applaud you all for coming on today.
What is your position on the Michigan DNR or DNR uses now doing? How do you think they're doing? And if anything, what would you change?
Well, they're not doing a very good job. If it takes 2 years to issue a permit for a business and they go someplace else and they get it done in 2 weeks, there's something seriously wrong with the permitting process. That is not cured by combining the DEQ, which is the agency issue of those permits, with the DNR. All we got out of that was more chiefs and Lansing. And one of the biggest problems we have is that we have too much power centralized in Lansing. And we need to get rid of some of the bureaucracy, the bureaucrats. You know, that means job cuts, unemployment, and state workers. But hey, that's the way it is out here for the rest of us.
What is your position on Michigan becoming a right-to-work state?
I favor that. I think that being forced into a labor union, we don't want to do it, is onerous. And that occurred to me when I was a young man. I got a job working at an auto parts supplier in Sable County. The first thing that they do is take you into the lunchroom and explain to you how it's going to be. And you're going to get a wage for 90 days, they're watching. Whatever the foreman says, after that, it's easy to do. That's not the way it should be. Most states that have right-to-work laws have much better unemployment figures than we do. It's not the answer to all of our problems, but it certainly helps.